Good morning, everybody. So good to see you. Happy Saturday. Let's get into our workout for our warm-up today. We will have 5 movements. We're going to do 3 rounds. For the first time through, we'll work 30 seconds on, 15 seconds of rest and transition. When we come to the second round, we're going to speed it up. It's going to be 20 seconds of work, 10 seconds of transition. And then for the last round, super duper quick, 15 seconds of work, 5 seconds of rest. I'll be counting you through so you don't have to worry about that. Just know your transition, you do a lot of hustle. So, those 5 movements, we are starting off with overhead object hold with a alternating forward lunge. So you're gonna take your weight and hold it up above your head. The entire time we're gonna lunge forward and back. Forward and back. If you feel like you've done a lot of forward lunging this week and you'd like to do a reverse lunge, be my guest. Just pick one and stick with it so we can get that nice good warm up. Number 2 is air squats. Our good old friend. Coming all the way down, all the way up. I'm going to get our butt in line with our knees. That's a very good thing. Then you're going to grab your object again. We're doing ground to overhead. So touch the ground, all the way up overhead. Using the momentum of standing up to help you propel that weight nice and high. Then we are going to come down onto the ground into a plank. Our object is going to be right in front of us, and we are going to tap the object back and forth. So practicing shifting our weight side to side, but we're not rocking our hips around. We really want to lock the floor, push the weight through our feet, switch hands without dropping the floor. Then finally, we're doing prisoner sit-ups. So you can do this with or without a weight. Prisoner sit-ups, you're flat on the floor, arms come up, you're going to sit all the way up, all the way down. If you're using a weight, holding me at the bottom, so all the way up, and all the way down. Okay, got one leg coming here. There we go. Come on in. I'm already warm, let's get this party started. Timer and we're going. So grab your odd object. You're going to hold overhead. You're alternating forward lunge. 30 seconds of work. 15 seconds of rest and transition. We will start in 3, 2, 1. Let's go. And lunge. Forward lunges. Good. Consistently working. Moving with control. And bring that knee down to the ground. Don't smash it. Just take your time. Gently hit the ground. Oh, I just picked my clock. And 3, 2, 1. Rest. Air squats are next. So enjoy these longer rests while we can. 15 seconds goes quick. 10 seconds even faster. Here it comes in 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Air squats. Back stays nice and straight throughout. Practicing getting down nice and low. You can do these as fast or as slow as you like. If you feel like holding the weight, whatever may be the case as you warm up, get after it. 30 seconds of work. Whew. Yeah. 3, 2, 1, and rest. Next, we will move into our ground to overhead. So grab that weight again, going all the way down, all the way up, over the top of our head, with the weight triangle, straighten the arms. 2, 1, let's go. All the way up. Always try to keep that weight really close to your body as it comes up and down. The further away from you it goes, the more you're going to find that puts pressure on your lower back. So, keep it close. Just clearing your nose, just clearing your chest. 3, 2, 1, rest. Down to the ground, weight out in front of you, in the plank, through the tap, out to the object. Here it is. 3, 2, 1,
position, reaching out in front. Just want it to be right at the end of the range of where you can reach without really needing to lose your form. Your work hips down, shoulders back, core engage, squeeze the glutes, push through those opposite toes. Keep my right hip on the ground, push a little harder on the other side. 3, 2, 1, rest. And for our last station is prisoner sit-ups. So laying down, we'll sit all the way up. Here it comes, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, good. Raise the core, all the way up, all the way down. If this one's challenging, you can bend the leg a little bit. There we go. So try to only have your heels on the floor. Good. Always the option for weight here. Keep working through. 3, 2, 1, rest. So, 15 seconds here, and then we're into our next round. Okay. 20 seconds of work. 3, 2, 1, let's fly that weight above head, forward lunging. 20 seconds for the 10 second transition this time. Halfway. Nice work. And 3, 2, 1, rest. Next is our air squats. We start in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, let's go. All the way down, all the way up. Make sure you get that full hip opening at the top. We're not trying to overextend the hips, just practicing making sure those hips get the full range of motion at the top and the bottom. 3, 2, and 1, rest. Next, you that round to your overhead. Grab that weight. We're starting in 3, 2, 1, do it. All the way up. Got it. Make sure your feet are flat on the floor. Pushing through the heels and the toes as you stand up. 3, 2, 1, rest. Down to the ground for our plank object taps. 3, 2, 1, let's go. 20 seconds. Just within reach. Play around with your hand placement. If you're feeling your wrist getting tired, you can try making a fist. Shoulders back. Take the arch out. 3, 2, 1, rest. And finally on our back foot, prisoner sit-ups. All right, 3, 2, 1, 20 seconds of work. Let's go. Oh, too long for this space already. Good work. Squeeze those abs, deep core, all the way down into the pelvic floor. Sit up nice and tall. 3, 2, 1, rest. Okay, moving quickly into our final round. 15 seconds of work, 5 seconds of rest. Starting in 3, 2, 1, fly that way. Let's go. Forward lunges. Woohoo! And 3, 2, 1, rest. Put that weight down in squats. And 3, 2, 1, let's go. Quick, that 5 seconds. Down to overhead next. So as soon as we finish, grab that weight and get ready. And 3, 2, 1, rest. 3, 2, 1, let's go. 15 seconds. Hustle, hustle, hustle. We'll have to really get down to the ground nice and quick when this finishes in 3, 2, 1, rest. to let your weight move around too much for your hips. Nice and steady. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Rest onto your back. Prisoner sit up. 3, 2, 1. Not too distracting, you can still hear everything. Yeah? Okay, good. Let's talk about strength. So today we have 5 movements. There's no set timing for this. We're not going to have like the clock running for every minute on the minute. I just really want to make sure more than anything we can get them done well with good form. Continuously moving, not really having any meaningful breaks or rests throughout. We'll take a little time at the end of each 5 if we need it. We'll see how dead I am. So, movement number 1. We're doing Bulgarian split squats into an RDL on each side. So you're going to need a bench, something you can put your foot up on. If these are no for you, you can always simply do a split squat like so. But ideally, what we're going for is you're going to come down in the Bulgarian split squat, and we come up, we're going to tip forward into an RDL. So a lot happening here, really challenging for your balance, as well as your legs, which is what we're here to work out anyway in this movement. So notice, so we'll do 8 on each side, 8 total, so 8 split squat and RDL. You really want to make sure there's a good distance between you and the bench. This will be the fun one to try and wiggle around and get our form right for. When you come up, tipping forward into the RDL, I'm really changing where my back foot is quite a bit, like I'm changing half of the weight there. Find what's going to work for you and work within that range. More than anything, keep your back straight, keep the power in that leg that's on the ground, lots of work. And if the balance isn't there today, that's okay, go within your range. Then, we will be moving on to deficit sumo deadlifts or a standard sumo deadlift. If you have some books, that's something you can put your feet up on and then have a gap between so that there is where you're standing and then the weight's gonna sink even lower. Sumo deadlifts, make sure we have really wide feet, toes bring out at 45 degrees. When we sit down into this, it's a hip hinge, so pushing our hips back. Our knees don't move. They should stay exactly where they are, not travel forward. So we're coming down into our sumo, standing up. We're going to take our time to come down. The lower we have to bring it, the harder we're going to get those glutes working. And you'll probably feel your hamstrings work tomorrow as well. If you don't have the depths, like the steps or books that you feel comfortable on, standard sumo, all the way up, all the way down. Then we move on to pike push-ups. So coming down to the ground in a pike position. So pike position means arm in the air. You're going to bring our head to the ground and back up. Try not to let our elbows completely out to the side and more at a 45 degree angle. The closer you bring your feet, the harder this is going to be. You want to feel it in the lats. So you're pulling your shoulders back, working very hard through here. Of course, everything else is always working because that's what we do here. Then, moving into dolphin planks. So dolphin plank, in your standard plank position, we're going to push back into a downward dog position and back to plank. I don't know why it's called dolphin, but I'm sure there's a reason. I can't think of. When we're coming through, one thing to think about, don't let your back arch. You're not trying to drop your hips. I Great way to counteract this is to think about almost like rolling your spine. Come back like you should, like so. That's going to be a good practice for engaging those lower abdominal muscles in all of your other plank and quad movements. Then, finally, we'll do Aquaman's. So, we've all done Superman's by this point. So, if this is a Superman, Aquaman is pretty much Superman swimming. So, we're going to raise our right leg and our left arm like a bird dog, back down. So, never letting our limbs touch the ground. If you can go faster and not fall over and keep your coordination, that's your challenge today. Let's see what we can do. So, just to quickly recap before we get started, we're doing 8 Bulgarian split squat plus RDLs on each side. It's gonna take the longest to come through. Then we're into 12 deficit deadlifts, or standard sumo deadlifts. Then we are doing 8 to 10 pike push-ups, taking our time, we're not trying to rush, we want to nail this long. Then 10 dolphin planks, switching back and forth from plank to downward dog, and then finally 40 seconds of Aquaman's. We're doing it 4 times, so grab some water, and then we'll just get going. All right, so there's no timer on this one. I'll simply count us in and we'll go from there. So once I can, once we're all in position, we'll begin. Shoelaces are on the bench. Let's go together in 3, 2, 1. So down to the Bulgarian split squat, hinge for the remaining deadlift. Down, up. Nice and consistent with the movements as much as possible. Try not to let your knees cave in or collapse in towards your midline. Gentle on that knee that's touching the ground. Down and up, down and up. Should be feeling those glutes right about now. Woo-hoo! I know I am. 7. One more on this side. And then we'll switch. Whew. Thank goodness. So, have a leg forward, shoelaces back on your bench. Let's go. And down, up, hinge, return. Down, up, hinge, return. Powering through. The heel when we're coming up out of that Bulgarian split squat and in your RDL. We're going from a hip hinge into a squat movement, so we're hitting every core muscle in our legs. Trying to take care of our core, come up nice and tall every time. Back straight throughout. This is 7. We are going to switch into the deficit sumo deadlift. We are doing 12. And find your position. Here we go. In 3, 2, and 1. Coming up tall, push the hips back to sit down. Up. 3, 2, 1 to come down. If you've got a heavier weight and you want to hit 12 and you want to come down a bit faster, by all means, alternatively, if you're feeling a bit light, take a little longer. That negative position we move through, the slower and more controlled we can do that, the more tension we're putting our muscles under, and the better result we get. So keep moving, try to be consistent, no breaks. 12 total. Work. 3, 2, 1. I think that's for me. As you are finishing up there, moving onto the ground floor, your pike push-ups. Let's come down into position together. Remember, pike means hinge of those hips, butts in the air, pointing your feet out to your hips, the heart of the up, 8 to 10. Bring your hands to the ground, push up. Keep your shoulders back, away from your ears. You're gonna feel it in those lats, down below your shoulder blades, into the side, into the back of your ribs. Moving with control.
Sweating, I have it like all through everywhere. It's nuts today.
It's gonna be warm. So good. Okay, so let's go again in 10 seconds. So you are going to grab your weight to your Bulgarian split squat Romanian deadlifts, moving consistently. Sorry, here we go. Try that again. So, shoelaces on the bench, elbows down in front. Let's go. Down, up, hinging, and return. Up. Try two. Again, move through the full range of motion. Chest out nice and proud. Shoulders are not moving throughout this. Shoulders forward. Take a second to reset. You're here. Pull their shoulders back. Pull the core into alignment. Power through the leg. Switching sides. Nice consistent movement. Here we are. Down. Up. Hinge. Return. If you are finding that the weight is quite challenging and the form is suffering as a result, try using just one weight, less weight, including no weight, that's the right option for you. You know what it's supposed to feel like. You know how to work hard. I trust you made a good decision for yourself here. Oh no, less than that last one. That's a needle one from next time. As soon as you're done, let's come into our position. Or the sumo deadlift, deficit or not, all up to you. Here it comes. In 3, 2, 1, let's go. 12, all the way up. Coming down to your weight hits the floor. Squeeze the glutes to stand up. If you're starting to feel this in your lower back, you're going to need to think about what's happening in your hips, and especially trying to drive through your heels. You want more engagement from the posterior chain. That's all the muscles through the backside of your body, your posterior, to help you maintain that position. I said it once, I'll say it again. Shoulders are back, arms are up, really moving in this position. Give me 12. Gosh, I hope that's 12. Feels like 12. As soon as you've done 12, let's come onto the floor. We're doing our pike push-ups. Try to challenge yourself with the angle of the pike. Let's come down into position, 8 to 10. Up. Hand down front, touch your head to the ground. Let's go. Down and up. Whatever pace is working for you. Straight legs. If you've got tight hamstrings like me, then you're going to have as straight a leg as you can manage. Take a quick sip of water or a quick drink. We're going again into our dolphin push-ups, sorry, dolphin planks. 10 this time. So let's find our plank position and go again. Pushing up, back to plank. Hit pause in each position. Moving slow and with control. Rotate the hips under, tuck the tail. Even when you've got your hips pushed high in the air, you can still have that forward rotation, that like tucked under rotation of your hips. You're gonna use your core muscles to keep it there. Good. Keep moving. 10 total. Lots happening in your shoulders right now. Woohoo! Once you hit 10. Get ready for your Aquaman. I can't see you because you're all on the ground, so I'm just going to have to assume that means we're ready to go. Coming up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 40 seconds. Aquaman or Superman. And if you have cranky shoulders, try to do the same thing with your arms pulled back. Lots of shoulders, lots of back today, guys. Let's get it done. Halfway. Pull our upper body and lower body up off the ground. Alternating which hand and which leg moves. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Rest. Honestly, very sweaty today. I'm so excited that it's warm, but that makes it tougher up here. The glass is gonna come off, guys. Can't see through them anyway. We are gonna move into our next round shortly. Just grab a quick sip of water. Here it comes. So, as soon as you're ready, Grab your weights. Time for our Bulgarian split squat to Romanian deadlift. Again, if you don't have the bench, split squats are on the ground. Here we go. Down, up, down, and up. That's tough. That's not even any easier. Eight on each side.
Losing count, so I'm trying to do an extra one or two to make sure I don't skip anything.
As soon as you're ready, down into the ground for your acrobat. This is the only one I think I'm actually counting correctly. 40 seconds of work. Coming up. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's do it. Lifting the opposite arm, opposite leg. Again, if you're feeling quite challenged by this position, maybe it's starting to take a toll on something you don't want it to, hit that Superman position and hold there. Alternatively, to crank the shoulders, pull the arms back, really squeeze the shoulder blades together, pull yourself back up off the ground. You have 10 more seconds. Three, two, one, rest. Right here. Trying to channel my bestie Bowen there. So, grab that last sip of water. We're going into round four. Trying to keep it strong. Trying to keep the form really tight as we go through. We're getting tired now. So this is where all of that hard practice that you've just put in, we're going to put it to the test. You can see yourself in the monitor. Always a great way to check your form. Do what you can. We'll get started here. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's do it. Down, up, hinge. Don't be afraid to rejig your form as you go through. Are you falling off the bench? Are you tipping around? Take a second. This is your workout. Try to keep those hips square. Don't want them to tilt up to the side. We're rounding out. Oh, good work. Engage the core. Use those stabilizers. Sitting back into the Bulgarian split squat. In squat at the hip. Your remaining deadlift. Have done 8. Come into your deadlift position. You know what you're doing here. You've worked out the timing. You've worked out the core. You've worked out the back. So let's get it done. 12. Sumo deadlift. Negative if you can. Let's get it going. 3, 2, 1. Good. Thrusting the hips forward. Come up. Weight in the heels. As you sink back, push through the heels as you stand. Look at your knees. What are they doing? I hope they are not collapsing inwards or tracking forward when you bend down. Push those babies out, away from each other, and let them travel. Shoulders back, finish strong. My back is so worked today. This is so good, guys. Take 1 second. And bring yourself down into your pike position. 8 to 10. Pike push-ups. Make sure you're active through the shoulders. We're never slouching or collapsing or rounding. Here it goes. Pike. 8 to 10. Head to the ground. tough. 10 seconds, and then we will come into our dolphin plank. Plank to plank, back and forth 10 times. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Do it with me. Let's push back, pause, forward, pause. Back, pause, forward, pause. Reminder, I'm going to give myself here. Let's push my heels back into the ground. When I'm in my downward dog. Reminder, you might need is to take care of your back, don't let your hips drop. It might be keep those shoulders engaged. It might be to push hard through the hands you push back. Whatever it is, find ways to improve what you're doing throughout. There's no such thing as perfect. Last one we're doing is the Aquaman. So come down to the ground. I'm gonna get my club ready. Let's go together in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hit it. Little kicks. If you can go faster and it looks good, you're not just wiggling around, by all means, be my guest. You want to be stationary. If you need to pull your hands back, whatever it looks like. You've got 15 seconds left. Conditioning. This is a tough one coming up. You should be sweating pretty good right about now. Oh, loving your work. So there's a few concepts to explain for the conditioning today. This will be timed. So we want to move through the workout as quickly as possible. Every time, so this workout's called Cindy, or like first, the best way. Apparently I can't think and work out. So we are going to be doing a certain number of Cindys today. One Cindy is 10 push-ups and 10 air squats. Whether that's on your knees or on your toes, that's 10 push-ups you can do, nice and quick. And then you come up onto your feet, rip out 10. Then, so as we go through today, we are going to do a certain number of repetitions of Cindy, then we're going to break it up with another movement. So, to review, we are doing 4 rounds of Cindy, so 10 push-ups, 10 air squats, repeated over and over 4 times. If you want to do 40-40, be my guest, I don't recommend it, break it up. Do what you can. As soon as you've done 4 rounds of Cindy, next thing you're doing is 40 rounds overhead. So taking your odd object, need this a lot for this workout, all the way down, all the way up. If you need to take breaks, you take breaks, but keep moving, it's your time. As soon as you've done your 40, round to overheads. Now we're in the 3 rounds. So, 3 rounds of Cindy. 10 push-ups, 10 air squats, 3 times through. Then you do 30 weighted squats. So, holding your odd object, whatever weight you've got, 30 squats. Make them real squats. You will have done quite a lot of air squats at this point. So pick a pace that feels good and consistent for you. Take breaks where you need it. Then, that's our 3 round, then the 2 rounds. So 2 sets of Cindy. 10 push-ups, 10 air squats twice through. Then we're gonna do 20 thrusters. So, by this stage, I think I'll be using a small weight. Start all the way down, all the way up. Using the momentum as you come up out of your squat, you thrust your weight up overhead. If at this stage your squatting is starting to feel pretty gnarly, then I would suggest maybe switching that out for snatches. So 10 on one side, 10 on the other, but aim for thrusters, gauge down for the others, and then for your final round, one round of Cindy and 10 burpees, 10 push-ups, 10 air squats, 10 burpees, then we're done. Easy, right? Isn't that awful? So I'm going to get my clock ready. You are going to have a final sip of water, say a small prayer to whoever you might make those to. And we'll get going. Starting my timer in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You've done 4 Cindy's. Come into 40 grand or overhead with me. Good heavens. Breaks where you need them. Cracking through, guys. Just take the breaks where you need them. Pick it up, go again. You want to use your breathing? Exhale at the hardest part of the movement. Ground to overhead as soon as you can. You're in the 3 round. So three Cindy's and then 30 weighted squats. Modification if you're in need. Switch those Cindy's to seven with everything. Seven push-ups, seven squats. Let's keep it moving. All right. Use that odd object to hold whatever weight you've got. All the way down, all the way up, and your weighted squats. Pull the weights wider up on your shoulders, wherever they feel good. You got a backpack, you can put that on. Stand up all the way. Get down lower. So for everyone in this, the order, four Cindy's. 40 ground to overhead. Three Cindy's, 30 weighted squats. Two Cindy's, 20 thrusters or 10 snatches on each side. And then one Cindy, 10 burpees. The modification is seven in the Cindy's instead of 10, so seven push-ups, seven air squats. Keep rolling, guys. Make sure your knees are not collapsing in when you're doing any squat, thruster, ground to overhead, anything. 20 thrusters or 10 snatches either side. Rolling.
You can do this. Keep rolling through. Woohoo! Hit those 10 burpees at the end. I just want to hold the clock for whoever's finishing up. I'll get them in a sec. Don't you worry, I'm not slacking. Keep moving. Good work. Come on, let's do it. All right, let's do it. Let's go. Hit the end. It's not over till it's over. Nice work, everyone. Looking so good. Woohoo! So close, guys. Watch that clock go. So good. So impressed with you people. Okay. Good. You're grinding them out. Thank you, Katie. Good work. Smash that. Krista, I see you. Good job. Come on, ladies. Let's make it happen. Love your work. Well done. Finish strong. It was the last sections were 2 Cindys, 20 thrusters, or 10 snatches each side, then 1 Cindy, then 10 burpees. You killed it. You're almost there. Till the end, let's go. All right. Thank you. You too, Krista. Have a great weekend. Love your work. Yeah, Teresa. Woo-hoo! Well done. Get it, girls.
Thanks.
Bye.
Bye.
At the end, let's go, everyone. Woohoo.
Thanks. Yep. See you later.
Bye. Thanks, Trisha. Thanks, Callie. Matt, you smashed that.
Ooh.
So good. Tara, Victoria, I can't see you, but I'm here for you. Woohoo! I'm gonna hit my burpees because I said I would. I'm shutting it down. 10 burpees is the finisher. We're at the 13:10 mark. Ladies, I love what you've done today. Such a good job. Thank you, Maverick. Thanks, everybody. Have a great weekend. Go get some sunshine. Bye.